thanks for getting the squad started, Eli. I appreciate that. If everybody can do two things, open the guild tab and join us in the guild hall. And if you get a little pop-up in the left side of your screen that says the map is full, do you want to join the new map? Click yes, please. That way, that's how it expands to fit everybody in the same instance. And also, if you could open vent chat, it's the third button down on the right-hand side. And Nylan, will you be recording the meeting tonight?
Yes, ma'am, I'm recording it now.
Once you get to the guild hall, I've asked all the chapter officers to line up across the steps here. Everybody else will be out there by the waypoint where you poured in, because I want you all to be able to see who your chapter officers are. So if we could have all the chapter officers up here on the steps, please.
I'm coming.
From right to left, we've got Zwinga, who's also known as Woods. He's our quartermaster. Then we've got Candid, who's also known as Valonaline. She's our vice PvE lord. And then we've got Elidia, that is also Elijah, and she's our captain. I'm right there next to her. Next, we've got Despion, who's our lieutenant. Next to her, we've got Althea, who is Arlessa, and she is our herald. Over there, kind of behind her, is Nylan, and he's our media manager. Azar just popped in. He's our vice warlord. And Kara Payne, who's kind of up there on the edge, she's our edgy warby world leader. All right, cool. I wanted to make sure I introduced all of our chapter officers so you guys will know who they are if you need something. All right. Well, as always, we want to start this meeting off with a big hail swarm.
Hail swarm.
I want to thank you all for being here. This is going to be a little bit different than our normal meetings. We've got a big event planned for this evening, and most of you know that we've been working towards our guild hall restoration. As most of you know, most of the buildings that are around here are sort of temporary structures, and basically they look like tents, but you can see behind them there is some construction going on. There's some cranes and scaffolding and things like that. You know, we're rebuilding from the rubble, basically. You know, this lost Golden City had been overtaken by the Mordrum. We came in and defeated them and took it away from them. And with the Consortium's assistance, we are rebuilding this guild hall. So, we will be having permanent structures very, very soon. I do want to thank everyone for your generous donations. Those of you who are sending scribe mats to agathu.1890, that's very much appreciated. Those of you who are donating to the treasurer, let's see, Eli, you've got the guild marker over your head, so would you go and stand by the treasurer and show them where that is, please? The things that are needed in this treasurer will change. As we progress and start making more upgrades, he'll have different things that are needed. So you can look in there and check and see if you have anything that's needed, but do check back if there's not anything at the time, because it will change. And those things are mats that we need to do our upgrades, along with favor, which we get from doing guild missions. That's the only way we can get it. And Ethereum, which we mine in our mine that's over on the other side of the guild hall. So I do want to thank everyone who came out and helped with guild missions last night. We were able to complete three guild missions successfully, so we were able to make over 1,200 favor, and I want to thank everybody for that. It was a great job, and we really need that favor to come in to continue. You know, we're going to be building here just in a few moments. We're actually going to be building our guild tavern, which will be the social hub for our guild to hang out and socialize together. And it will be our very first permanent structure. We're really excited about that. But don't forget, guys, we've got a lot more work ahead. So keep those donations coming. We're going to do our arena next, and then our market. We've got a workshop, a war room. We've got a lot to do still. So this is definitely not the end by any means. It is the beginning. So your continued support is very much appreciated. All right. Is there anyone here tonight who this is your first time in the guild hall? Okay, great. I guess everybody's already been in the guild hall at least once then. There are quite a few people who have thoroughly explored it, and if you would like a tour, check with one of our chapter officers who's up here on the steps, and we would be more than happy to give you a tour anytime. It's a really beautiful place, and there's lots of cool stuff in here. We did test, Kara had a free account for her kids, so she did log into that to see if she could get into the guild hall. She could, so even if you have a free account, you can get into the guild hall. If you don't have the Heart of Thorns expansion, you won't be able to access all the features because some of the vendors have items available that are HOT items. So you may not be able to interact with all of the merchants and things like that, but you will be able to get in the guild hall. Nylan is also recording this event, and he's streaming it on Twitch for anybody who does not have Guild Wars 2. So let's see, his comment, he does not have it in his comment. If somebody could post his Twitch channel up where everybody can see it in chat, that'd
be
awesome.
I got disconnected. I have to put it back in.
Oh, that's okay. That's okay, and I'm really excited because we're going to have this momentous occasion recorded to put up on the YouTube channel, so I love to have things like that to share with people because a lot of people don't know exactly what it is we do, and those videos give people a chance to see for themselves what's going on, so thank you, Nylan, for doing that. We really appreciate it. You do a fantastic job. Thank you so much. All right, guys, I'm going to do a few announcements just so that we can make sure everybody has had a chance to get here before we do the actual building of the tavern. It'll only take a few couple of minutes to do the actual building, and then we can all go in and check it out together. But we do have some announcements to make prior to that just to give everybody a chance to get here. So first of all, our PvE Lord Bayor is up. Bayor?
Howdy, folks. PvE, pretty much the only new PvE is out there in Heart of Thorns. The fractals have been adjusted a little bit, so we'll look at those. They're fun to do. Good rewards out of them. They did finally adjust the rewards to reflect the money that they took away from running the dungeons. Other than that, I have one announcement I'm going to put up. I have redone the thread for the Valentine's card exchange. Let me put it in the chat. Alright, it's now in the chat. Valentine's card exchange, if you have not participated in the past, works much like the holiday card exchange, except for what we do is we have everybody who's on the participation list, and if you want to be on the list, just PM me on the forum. And once we get the final number of people participating, we'll go out and we'll buy a box of those Valentine's cards, the ones that have a bunch of little ones in them, and we'll sign one for everybody, and then we'll put them in an envelope with another self-addressed stamped envelope to, and we'll send that whole thing to Fate, and Fate agreed to parcel them out and then put them back in the envelope you address to yourself and put stamps on. Crucially, you put stamps on it, and she'll send it back to you. So you'll get a card from everybody on the list. So it's kind of like the old, you know, school box where you put it on your desk and you got a little Valentine's card from everybody. It's a fun thing to do. If you're interested, again, check out the link, PM me on the forums, and I will put you on the list. And that's all I have.
Thank you, Bayor. This is a really, really fun event. I love it. It's really cool to see all the different Valentines that people pick out or make, and all of them are different, and it's fun to see where they come from, and it's just a really fun event. It's good to share the love. Alright, let's see, next up, we've got Elijah, and she's going to be talking about PvP and a new cosplay event coming up. Eli, you're next.
Yes, ma'am. We've had two previous cosplay events. One was our original cosplay event to celebrate the new Lion's Arch, and our second one was our Halloween event. Both were great events, and we had a great turnout. I'm hoping we'll have a great turnout for this one. This one's going to be themed Fashion Week, and we're going to have a fun time with all our own individual fun fashions, and we'll have a couple of different categories to participate in, and and I hope to see all of you there. I'll get a post up when we have all the dates and times figured out, and again, I hope to see all there. Of course, each week we have our STVP event, which happens before Farming Night on Tuesdays. We've had a great turnout, and we've had some great fun doing our PvP. We hope to eventually get our PvP group figured out and start working on the professional part of Guild Wars 2 PvP. And but I'm very, very happy to see how many people are interested in it and are having fun with it. And please feel free to ask me anytime if you're interested in the SPVP team. And have fun with the ranked event that is happening currently in the SPVP, which should be ending near the end of January. I'll hand it back to you, Fate.
Thank you, Eli. And if Eli has to leave early, she's not feeling well. And if it's the same stomach bug that I had, mine lasted 3 days, and it was horrible. But I'm feeling better now. I hope you get better soon, Eli. And thank you for making this special extra effort to be here. We appreciate you.
No problem. Glad to be here.
All right, next up we've got Kara, if the baby allows her to share with us about World v. World, just really quick.
Yeah, World v. World's gonna we're kicking it back off this week. I know with the holidays and everything, I know I was extremely busy last month. I didn't get much playtime at all. But I do know they did make at least one change. I do know they made, they reduced the cost of Katas for us, which is great. But other than that, we'll see you Friday. Bye, Two-Face.
Thank you, Kara. I hear Christian in the background.
He's hungry and wants to go to bed.
I don't blame him. I kind of want to go to bed, too, but I always want to sleep, so. Anyway, next up we've got Arlesta. She's our herald. She's been doing a great job of getting a post together for our next recruitment drive. We've always got recruitment on our minds. Probably every chapter in this forum is always got its mind on recruiting, because if we're not growing, we're dying. You know, we've got to keep that new fresh blood coming in. So, Arlesta, you're up next.
Alrighty, hello everybody. I will start off by putting up the forum post about the recruitment drive we have launching today. Just a moment. Alright, so that is the post for the recruitment drive that we are launching today, our first meeting of the new year. Alright, so like with our past recruitment drives, it's going for a month, so it's going to go until February 7th. You know, as I'm sure many of you know, we've had some awesome new content coming in with Heart of Thorns, content that is greatly enhanced if we have more and more people, whether it's doing the big hero point events in the new zones or doing some of the awesome new missions that we've gotten, or, you know, building up the guild hall. You know, it's all stuff that benefits a lot if we can kind of get a bunch of people together and all work together. So this, you know, recruitment drive is a great opportunity to bring in some new people, not just to, you know, play with us and be in the swarm, but to be, you know, awesome friends and to help us explore all of this new content with us. Obviously, like Faith said, you know, recruitment's always on our mind, but we like doing these recruitment drive events, kind of give people a little extra incentive to recruit, kind of maybe get them into it, you know, show them the awesomeness that is bringing in new swarmers. And we've got some great loot. But before I talk about the raffle that's going to be occurring as part of the recruitment drive, in that thread, it has some tips for the recruitment drive, stuff like what to do every day, you know, visit every city and put, you know, a recruitment blurb in the map chat. The link to the recruitment blurb thread that I talk about every meeting is in that thread. All the links are highlighted in light blue to make it a little easier for you to find. So we've got some tips for what to do every day. If you recruit a newbie, then you immediately get a stack of 10 heavy moldy bags, which they have. You have a good chance of getting some T6 masks out of those. And you also get a lottery ticket to the raffle. Once you recruit someone, just send them on to, you know, either one of the KVKs or to me, or if you need an orientation, definitely hit up Valonaline if you can, because she needs more orientations for her Killer Bee quest. So like I said, you get an immediate lottery ticket to the raffle if you recruit a newbie, and now on to the raffle prizes. I'm donating some of the prizes that I actually won in the last recruitment drive. So stuff like a Devil Dog Mini, a choice of a mini from the bottom tab of the Guild Bank, a choice of a rare die from the bottom tab. Cole Thera mentioned that he'd be up for donating some exotic weapon skins. We're going to be having more information on what's going to be in the prize pool to kind of let you guys know what you could be winning. Also, the swarmer who recruits the most newbies, at least two, during the drive is going to get a special prize. We'll let you know what that is in a little bit, probably in the coming weeks. Also, as we get more recruits up to Worker Bee, we're going to be adding even more prizes to the prize pool. This is similar to the way we've done it in the past. We're adding stuff like 18-slot bags and even a precursor into the raffle prize pool. So this is going to be a great way that you can win some cool items, you know, stuff like minis, dies, mail carriers, you know, stuff that you would get from the little black lion chests. It's very cool, the sort of things that you can win. I've gotten some really cool stuff in the past. But, you know, like Fate said, we want to just have this as an addition to our normal recruiting. We're hoping that this, you know, we'll kind of get some people into recruiting and kind of teach them about it and kind of let them try their hand. You know, it's great both for the chapter and, you know, just in general, it's a lot of fun. You know, you can really get some great friends out of it. You know, even for, you know, people who haven't been in the swarm for very long, only a few months, you know, they really do, you know, become like family to us, like people that we brought in, you know, during the last recruitment drive, like Despion, and I believe Alchemist also came in during that time, and, you know, we get some really great friends out of it, you know, not just to play the content, but also, you know, just additions to the swarm family. All right, so I believe that that is pretty much all that I have for you today. Before I pass it back to Fate, does anyone have any questions related to the recruitment drive? Alrighty, well, back to you, Fate.
Alright, thank you, Arlessa. And recruiting doesn't have to be any hard kind of science or anything like that. It can just be as simple as saying hi to somebody, making a new friend, offering to help somebody, or show them around if they're a new member. Tango can tell you how he got recruited. I was showing a new member around in one of the lobby zones, and I came across him, and I thought his name was cool, and I just kind of invited him to join our group with us to help help him get some of those quests done. What did you think back then, Tango? He may be AFK, actually.
He's doing work at the moment, but he's listening.
Oh, okay, cool. He's really busy. He's going to school and working and stuff, and doing some really...
Can you hear me?
Oh, yes, now we can.
Yeah, sorry about that. I thought you liked my name, which, you know, I like that you liked my name, and yeah, there you go.
So, folks, it doesn't have to be anything difficult. I mean, if you like somebody's armor or you just want to compliment them on their, you know, look or whatever, just to strike up a conversation with them, you know, well, hey, what are you doing? Can I help you with that? You know, send them an invite. You know, if they're doing heart quests, go help them with their heart quests. I'm sure you've done them before, so it won't be hard for you. And just get to know them a little bit. If they seem like they're a good fit, you know, all you got to do is answer any questions they might have, and we've got a link that has answers to frequently asked questions. You can always holler at one of us if you don't know the answers, and just then direct them to the website. If they like what they see, they can fill out a little intro form on the applications form, and then just let Arlessa or any of the KBKs know so we can send them the vent info, and then you don't have to do anything past that point. If you want to join them up in the guest lobby and welcome them and sit in on their orientation, that's always a plus, but you don't have to. We don't require that. But just getting them steered in the right direction is really all it takes. And just being friendly. So it could be just as easy as telling somebody you like their name. So it's really not hard. All right. I want to thank all of our chapter officers for sharing about the different areas that we have. And I just want to remind everybody, this is your chapter. You have a voice. We want to, you know, we want you to be heard. If you have any suggestions, ideas, you know, of course, you're always welcome to write us anytime on the forum or invent or send us an email. But the meetings are also a time where we like to open up the floor and see if anybody has anything at all to share. So you should all have the event chat open. If anybody wants to share anything at all, just type /raise and I'll pass you the microphone. It could be anything game related, or even if you've just had an accomplishment, you know, in real life, something that you want to share, which I think Lonaline has something to share. Or if you just want to give a shout out to a swarmer who's been especially helpful. All right, Tango, you've got a raise. Go ahead, Tango. Let's give Tango a big house swarm. That's great to hear. Awesome news. Thanks for sharing that. All right. Valonaline, you have the next raise.
I know you're excited because you already know what it is. Hail swarm, everyone.
Hail swarm.
For those of you that don't know, Pure Caliber here in the channel with us tonight is my husband. He and I are expecting our first child, and we just found out yesterday we're having a baby girl.
Yay!
Yeah!
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 Congrats!
Congratulations!
Thank you.
We love the baby bees. Yay! Aha, Kara. Christian's such a precious little boy. Alright, let's see. Azure, you've got a raise. You're next.
Pretty excited about it. I got a newer car on Tuesday. My first fully funded, completely owned by me car. So I'm very happy. I was with my old O2 Focus for like 9.5 years. So I switched on Tuesday into a new vehicle, 2012 Subaru Impreza. Very excited.
Congratulations!
Yeah, awesome.
I was wondering which one you were going to choose. I think you made a good choice.
Yeah, I'm very happy with it.
We'd love to see a picture on the forum.
I could arrange that, I think.
Awesome. These are great shares, everybody. Let's see, Wood, you're next.
I'd like to thank Valonaline and Eli, and I forget who else came with us on the dungeon run we had yesterday. It's the first dungeon run I had ever done when we defeated every single boss first time. It was a great run. Thank you.
My impressive knowledge of COE finally came in handy.
Yeah, and a big thank you to Arlesa and Eli for helping me. They're like, we know how to do this dungeon. And the other person was Pure Caliber, my husband. He was the other member of our group.
Great job, guys. It's awesome to see you guys sharing your knowledge and working together for the good guild. So keep it up. Doing awesome. All right. Does anyone else have anything to share? Just type /raise. All right. If no one else has anything to share, we're going to go ahead and... is everybody in the guild hall? If you're not and you need directions on how to get in the guild hall, just let me know. You simply type G to bring up the guild tab and then click go to the guild hall. And Eli has marked me with a yellow Dorito over my head. And I'm going to ask everyone to follow me, please, over in this direction. This is our temporary tavern over here. You can see, I guess it'd be good probably for us to line up along the top of these steps here. I want to make sure that Nylan has a good view of it since he's going to be recording it. Basically, what we're going to do is we're going to activate an upgrade that is going to build our tavern so that we'll have a permanent structure to go in and hang out. It'll sort of be the social hub. Now, this is the first building that we have completed in our guild hall, and everyone has been working very hard, and this is thanks to everyone. And So in just a moment, I'm going to run down there and activate it. And I have seen the animation on the official Guild Wars video that they had put out about guild halls. And it doesn't last very long, so you'll have to pay attention or you might miss it. But there should be some rumblings and some dust flying up, and then you should start seeing back there behind the tent. You can see kind of where there's some cranes and some scaffolding and all that, where there's some rubble of a building that looks like it's being rebuilt. So that's where you need to focus your attention, over there behind the red tent. And that's where you're going to see the tavern up here before your very eyes. Does anybody have any questions before we start?
Might I suggest putting away pets and mini pets so we don't have obscured views?
That's a good idea.
Well, if you're looking on Twitch from where I'm sitting, I'm not viewing any of you all, and I'm just looking at the tavern.
Hail Swarm! Alright, we're getting a cutscene if you're in game.
Move that bus!
I hope everyone can see this on Twitch.
It even came with moss.
Wow.
Alright. That was so awesome. Everybody come check out your new guild hall. I mean, guild tavern. I'm so excited I can't talk.
A new comment from our tender, innkeeper.
Is it really safe to have a tavern with open windows and a cliff behind it?
No.
We can
glide in here. I think it's safe.
Yeah. That's all inebriated Nords can glide when they're.
I think they more drop like a rock.
Yay!
This water fountain thing is pretty cool.
This is awesome.
No you're falling asleep in it.
It's like the world's greatest fountain.
Oh yeah, the waterfalls come down the side, and oh, they're really pretty. There's a pool, and on one side, and then the other side, it goes all the way down to the water below. This is really cool.
I don't know if it was here before, but there's kind of this big gazebo sort of thing where Kara and I are. Calling it a gazebo makes it seem a lot smaller than it is, but it's really cool and it's really pretty.
It is indeed. Wow, this is gorgeous.
I like the tables. Got like a glass center. Kind of look fancy.
Yeah, they do.
If you don't like to stand up there at the top of that waterfall, I can take a picture.
Oh, just tell us where you want us.
Where the bear's at. Just spread out.
Okay, guys, come over to where my yellow Dorito is, and you can stand here, and he'll take our picture.
I'm away.
And as soon as he takes the picture, I need to check on one thing. I may have a little surprise for you. Are you still here, Kara?
Yeah, I'm here.
Alright.
I can't move very much. Unless somebody has a little around.
Okay, I think we've got everybody up here for the picture, Nylan.
Okay, remember, if you can't see my head, the camera can't see you. Hang on. Thank you.
Okay, I'm going to jump on Nylan Holmes.
Hey, you guys want to see something absolutely hideous?
What's that?
Here, line up here on the hill and watch me when I jump.
Oh, man. Those gliders.
They'll be yours for 400 gems.
Alright, I promised you guys... I'm sorry, I promised you guys a surprise. If you guys could all make your way over to my yellow Dorito tag and line up over here by this beautiful fountain, I have a surprise for you all. Nylan, if you could record this, I would really appreciate it.
Yes, ma'am. Running fast as I can to get to you. I'm a Nord. I got fluffy.
Yeah, Kara, I'm glad you're here.
Are the slowest of all of them I've ever made.
Everybody will kind of want to stand back by the fountain.
Spread out so I get to know.
Yeah, spread out. You're going to want to look up at... Okay, you can see there's the temporary arena ahead of us has the blue and the red flags, and then over to the left of it, there's a pile of rocks and rubble, and there's some scaffolding, and you can see what looks to be a tower there in the background, kind of. That's what you're going to want to focus on. Is everybody here?
Oh, I see what you're doing. Let me get a better spot.
Okay.
I didn't figure out what you were doing, but now I know.
It was a surprise to everybody.
Yes, well, I'm still looking for a camera spot.
Take your time.
It's a shame you can't get on top of the fountain.
I can't?
Well, if there's a way, I'm sure Eli would figure it out.
Eli, get up there and port me.
I'm not on the nursery!
Oh, I'm trying to get to where I get all the pics and everyone. Alright, I got
it. I'm super excited about this, guys. You have no idea. This is a... I know, Eli's literally jumping for joy. You guys have heard about guild versus guild. So let me tell you a little bit about what that is. It's different than world versus world. Out in world versus world, it's kind of an open area, and there are three sides pitted against each other, just kind of an open combat. Guild versus Guild is where guilds who have their own custom arena can invite other guilds to come and have tournaments and battles and skirmishes and things like that. They can also have inter-guild tournaments to declare champions for the month and all sorts of fun things. So that is something we have really been looking forward to ever since they told us we were going to have guild halls, is that we were going to be able to have custom arenas and be able to have guild versus guild combat. So that's what we want to bring to you now, is our very own Sinister Swarm Custom Arena. Alright, so, Nylan, you let me know when you're ready. Everybody turn your attention towards the scaffolding, and just tell me when. You ready?
Recording and have it with, you know, the alt H so that I'm seeing everything.
All right, for our very own Sinister Swarm Custom Arena Restoration, in 3, 2, 1, Hail Swarm!
And did you see we just hit guild level 25?
We are awesome.
This looks amazing on Twitch.
Oh, it's so awesome.
Wow.
What?
Alright guys, come on and check out your new arena.
I want to get a fish and punt it off.
Not me.
Follow me. Okay, guys, come up here. See these different colored little people over here? These are your accesses to the PvP arena. You click on one of them, you'll be brought in, you'll be that color. Whoever's another color, you'll be up against.
Look at that dragon. That is so awesome with our swarm banners on either side. This is gorgeous. It's breathtaking.
Wow. Does this mean we can start putting up our guild tabbers we got when we bought the game with the thingy?
Once we get all our buildings done and see where everything's at, then we're going to start working on decorating it.
Okay. I've got a token in my pocket burning a hole.
Oh, you can still go over to the merchant that's over near the waypoint when you come in, and you can turn it in there and it'll go into the treasury of decorations.
Oh, okay. Now, how do I get in there?
Talk to the red guy.
Don't go in the red. There's already too many red people.
Oh, sorry.
It makes a lot more sense.
How do you switch?
When I turn the icons back on. If I go to blue, you guys are going to wipe me out. Like Eli wipes me out just looking at me.
I'm not on my neck.
I know, Necro Reapers are insane in PvP.
There's too many people, it's 3 against, like, 6.
I hope you guys enjoyed the surprise. It was something I had planned for tonight, but it is brought to you by all of the generous donations of people who have been contributing to the Guild Treasury, and we couldn't have done this without all of you.
That's right, come get me.
Why is Bale always against me?
Hey, take it easy on the blown one. She's in a delicate condition.
Hey, I was trying to move Canada.
There's a lot of red out there.
No, that's not a lot.
That's not fair.
I would be near, but I have the baby on me, and I don't have very good moving abilities at the moment.
Some things to look forward to, guys. We will be reinstating our monthly tournaments. and that means we will be having a champion again, a PvP champion of the month, and they will get some sort of prize as well. We were doing some different things before. We may revisit or come up with something new. We'd give them a different SIG tag to show that they were the PvP champion for that month, and they'd get the title on vent and in the forums and all that fun stuff. So it's kind of a prestige thing. So I think you all enjoy it, in addition to bringing in our other guilds. And I think that'll be really fun.
Does this mean we can do our daily PvPs up here together to get our daily stuff?
I don't think that that counts in the custom arenas. I think you have to be in the rated ones. I'm not really for sure, though, since this is the first time we've had this, and not many of the guilds have this yet. Surprisingly, guys, you know, Agathu is our official guild scribe, and he was telling me that, you know, some of the larger, very large guilds, you know, that have like 400 or 500 people, they were bragging about being level 24 a couple weeks ago and stuff like that, and we were 22 at the time. So we have really done amazingly well as far as our upgrades and how quickly we've been able to get these done, and I'm really, really super proud of all of you guys.
It took 5 of you to bring me down when I wasn't looking.
Yes.
For shame. For shame. I wasn't looking until I was half health, and then I started moving. He noticed I was standing still for the first half of my life part.
I tried to jump on top of you. You're too tall.
I
don't think Bear can give any of us a piggyback ride.
Is our meeting done? May I go ahead and end the recording?
Yes, thank you very much, Nylan. You guys can just enjoy the arena, have some skirmishes, whatever you want to do, hang out in the tavern. Don't forget, guys, the tavern proprietor still has enhancements you can get that are free. When you buy them, they don't cost you anything, but you can get buffs to get extra experience, to get gathering, extra gathering, and to get extra magic find. So you can get those buffs on your characters anytime you want, and they last 24 hours each.
And I'm looking at the treasure, seeing if anything new's opened up. Apparently, we can have an arena brawling green team and have a three-way contest.
Yeah, there are additional upgrades for the arena, but tonight we are just very thrilled and excited to have an arena. This is something we have been dreaming of for a very long time, and that's why I didn't tell anybody. I wasn't sure until a couple of days ago if we were going to be able to pull this off or not, so I kind of kept it under my hat. But I'm really, really happy. I mean, even just getting the tavern tonight would have been just such an accomplishment, but I was hoping for the arena as well, so I'm very excited. Next thing that we're going to do is our market restoration, and then that will allow us to, that's one of the requirements that we have to have in order to get the Guild Hall Decorations Merchant available at the market. Once that proprietor is instated at the market, then Agathy will be able to advance in his scribing. So that's something we really, really need in order to do that. As soon as we're able, we're going to, the next restoration will be the market.
And what do we need for that?
I'll go over there and I will tell you exactly in just a moment. Let me get over there real quick. Actually, that's what we were going to need. I had asked Wood to add the, actually, how do I get out of this arena, Eli?
Go to the waterfall.
Jump, there is the little portal, right behind Sienna, down at the base there.
Okay. I'm on my way, Woods. I'm on my way over there. Yeah, you can actually just port out if you're in the arena too, and you can just go to the portal. The waypoint. You were asking what we need, Nylan, and,
So, we used to have a forum post where we were posting what we needed. Are we still doing that?
Woods is in charge of that. Yeah, Woods has got the forum post going, and I think he's updating that. Okay, what we need as far as the market restoration, we need to have the market restoration one, which we have. As far as the mats concerned, we have plenty of mats. We don't need any additional mats. We have in a favor, what we need is aetherium, and the way we get that is from the mine, and it builds up over time. Currently, we have 3,021 aetherium, and we need a total of 5,000 aetherium, so we're more than halfway there. We may be able to get it next week at our guild meeting, hopefully, but that's the only thing we need at this time. I was afraid we did not have enough globs of Vecto, but due to some generous donations that were actually made just tonight, we now have enough globs of Vecto. That was the only thing that I was missing for this. That's why I asked Wood to add it, but I ran over here to look and see, and somebody donated it right before the meeting, and so we now have enough Vecto. That was my my next thing. So thank you to whoever did that. We've got everything we need, and just we're going to have to wait for the Ethereum to build back up a little bit, and once it gets to 5,000, we'll be able to have our market. Now, as far as getting the, merchant that we need, it is required that we have that restoration done, and the things that we need, and this is something you can all help with. We have 100 of the 200 vials of linseed oil necessary for this upgrade. So we still need linseed oil badly. So if everybody can farm flax, there are some flax farms, there are two of them. And you, if you have any extra level 80s that you're not actively using, please park them at a flax farm. So every day you can just go in there and farm the flax and send it to agathu.1890. The quicker you do that, the quicker he can get the vial of linseed oil. And the other thing we need is we have 85 of 200 sheets of extra coarse sandpaper. What he needs for that is sand, coarse sand. You can get sand from doing a certain track of PvP, but the quickest way to get it is to go out to dry top at 40 minutes before each hour, and for that 20 minutes there is a sandstorm event. You can go kill dust mites and do events and get sand during that 20 minutes. So, and that can be done at any time of day. So if you play like late at night or early in the morning or midday, it doesn't matter. You can go out there at 40 after each hour, and you can do kill the dust mites and do the events out there and get the sand for 20 minutes. Woods has a route that he does every day, and he can get like 300 sand, silky sand, in that 20 minutes. I can't get that much yet, but it doesn't matter how much you get. Every little bit helps. So even if you can go out there and get 100 or 50, you know, that's going to help. And we're almost halfway there to the amount we need for this. Now, later on, we're still going to need linseed oil and sandpaper for other things. But right now, we've got everything we need except for those two items. Wood, if you want to go ahead and tell everybody about the sandpaper, and what I would like for you guys to do is after events, like whenever we get through with the dungeon or something, anybody that wants to go out there with Wood and gather sand, if you need it for your own something, you know, you're welcome to keep half and send half to the guild or whatever you want to do. I mean, the amount that you donate is totally optional, totally up to you. This is all, you know, voluntary. We're not going to force anybody to give anything, but it's just voluntary. But if you want to go out there and collect sand, we'll go ahead and tell them what they need to do to get the most out there.
Well, you have to be out there during the sandstorm, and there's two dust mite events, one at 40 after the hour, one at 50 after the hour, and there's some other events, and I won't go through all of them now. If anyone wants to learn how to do sand or learn how I do it, I'm happy to show you. If anyone can do better than me, please let me know. I want to collect sand as efficiently as possible. So, but like Faith said, any amount of sand is welcome. The main thing is you want to go out there with AoE weapons or weapons that can hit multiple creatures at once, because there's going to be a lot of people hitting those dust mites, and you just need to tag them quickly before they die so you get the sand drop. And anyone wants to go out there and do it, just let me know. I'll be happy to go out and show you how to do it. Show you how I do it. Not necessarily the way to do it, but how I do it.
Thank you, Liz. That's really some great points. You do want to take a ranged weapon out there. You do want to be level 80. You want to try to tag as many things as you can so that you'll get credit for them and stuff like that in the event. So, it'll be fun. You can do it any time of day because it's every single hour. It's at 40 till it starts. So, doesn't matter if you play, you know, early or late or whatever. You can still do it.
And while you're out there, we need quartz crystal. I can show you where the quartz crystal mills are if you don't know. Most of you probably already know. And you might want to go and fight the Spirit Queen. Where the Spirit Queen is, there is a rich quartz crystal mill. So that's a nice lever to do for quartz crystal. But sand is a number one priority and will probably be a number one priority for a while. Although flax may be right up there next to it. Things are changing, so I'll try to get the thread updated in the forum with the critical mats in the next day or two. Keep an eye on that thread, see if there's any changes I make to it, and go ahead and add on your comments to that thread with posting your own, saying, hey, this is what I do to get this, and let us know, because we want to be doing the best we can.
Thank you, Wood. And for those of you who don't know, if you look at where my yellow Dorito tag is on the map, I'm standing behind the temporary workshop tent. There are 5 synth nodes back here. If you don't know what synth nodes is, it's like when you're out farming for farming nodes, only these are synthetic ones. And they give you wood and, you know, vegetables and all different kinds of things. These have been upgraded a little bit, so they give you more now. But you can collect green wood here, which we also need. Agatha needs all the green wood we can get. I believe, is that still correct, Wood?
Yeah, green wood. We actually have a new requirement for green wood on the treasure. And we need green wood for a lot of scribe mats. Use green wood to a great extent. And any green wood that Agatha has goes quickly. So we always have a need for green wood.
How about plants?
Okay.
The planks are what we need. You can donate either. If you can make the planks, that'd be great. If you can't, donate the logs, and we'll make planks out of them.
That's great to know. Thank you. And if from this wood synth node, you will also get tenebrous crystals. You're going to want to hang on to those. We do not have the ability yet that when we get up to about 27 to 32, we'll start being able to get recipes to make tenebrous armor and weapons. These are really special. They're unique to our guild hall, and that's one of the factors that we took into consideration for choosing this guild hall, because these weapons are in swarm colors. They are very shadowy and dark. They have a kind of a smoky appearance coming off of them, and they're kind of translucent to gold with a translucent black filler inside. The swords and the shields look really awesome. There are some screenshots that I put up on the forum for you guys under the guild hall thread. But that's what you want to save those tenebrous crystals for, because you're going to need those to do your armor and your weapons. So it doesn't tell you that on them, so I just wanted to let you guys know to hang on to them, put them in your bank, stash them on a character or something. You're going to need them later. And technically, our guild meeting is over, folks, but I want to thank everyone who came, and I especially want to thank our special guests, Duchess Siana, excuse me for that slip, Duchess Siana is here, and we appreciate her making a special trip to visit us tonight. Thank you, Siana.
It was my pleasure. It was fun.
Hellswarm.
Hellswarm.
Welcome to Honor. Become part of our ranks and battle alongside of us.